Today, I'd like to tell you about one of my favorite creatures. Can you guess what it is? Here are some clues. It is in the insect family. It goes through a complete metamorphosis, which means it doesn't look anything like its parents when it hatches. It has six legs, two long flying wings, and two feelers for catching the scent of its next meal. And it sometimes has beautiful colors like blue and green. I suppose you are thinking I'm describing the butterfly, but no. My favorite insect does not flutter from flower to flower, but rather hurries from animal poo to animal poo. Introducing the dung beetle. Poo, or I should rather say feces. But luckily, because of the dung beetle, we are not up to our necks in it. This is because there are 7,000 different species of dung beetles that either roll the dung, bury the dung, or make their homes in it. But they all eat it. Here in Africa, dung beetles can get rid of a huge pile of elephant dung in just 2 hours. Dung beetles are very useful on cattle farms. In fact, 50 years ago, we had to send some of our hard-working African dung beetles to Australia. When the Aussie farmers first brought cows to Australia, the Aussie dung beetles couldn't cope. They were only used to dainty little kangaroo and wallaby poos, not huge, steaming mounds of cow dung. Soon, millions of flies swarmed the air. People could hardly breathe. But luckily, our dung beetles saved the day. Dung beetles are also very strong. The tallest dung beetle is the world's strongest animal. If my dad was that strong, he'd be able to lift 16 elephants. Dung beetles may be stronger than my dad, but they definitely have a better sense of direction than my mom. Every time rollers go around an obstacle, they stop, climb on top of their dung ball, and navigate using the scar. Dung beetles are actually very good parents. First, they make a lovely warm poo ball for their nest. Then, take turns to look after the eggs and larvae. Yes, they may be good parents, but not as great as mine.